All right, good afternoon. Welcome to our video today on Friday, October the 16th. I hope you're having a great day today, and I'm excited. This is the last video of the week until Monday, so we're going to try to make this one very enjoyable. Okay, I'd like to start off by saying yesterday's video, we have some results in. Now, I want to say that we have several folks that have not been able to vote yet, so this may change. But currently, yesterday's video, with Jochebed and Tabitha, we have currently a 50% to 50% tie. And so we'll see what happens with the remaining votes. But yes, Tabitha, also known as Dorcas, and Jochebed. So we'll see what happens there. But today we are going to move into our video. As you can see, we have number 14, Mary, the sister of Lazarus. She's a wonderful lady, and we're going to learn even more today about her. And then number 6 in our tournament rank is Ruth. We all know Ruth. So folks, I ask you, please be open-minded. As you hear this video today, I'm sure that everyone knows more and has heard more about Ruth. There's no doubting that. But I ask you to listen to who these ladies were, because in my personal opinion, this is so close today. So please listen carefully and vote for the one who inspires you more. So here we go. We're going to start off our video by looking at Ruth. Okay. Now, as we did yesterday, we're going to look at a few things. We're going to start off by looking at if you'll give me just a moment, please. We're going to start off by looking at her path in this tournament so far. Okay? And by saying path, what I mean is what happened so far in this tournament with Ruth. How did her first video go? That's what we're going to start off with. And then we will move into the rest of the information, okay? But now, let's start off by talking about her path in this tournament so far, okay? In the first round, if you remember, I think everyone enjoyed the video, we saw Ruth and Naomi, okay? Naomi. Now that's interesting because Naomi, of course, they're in the same story together. That is Ruth's mother-in-law, Naomi. And but anyway, why did Ruth have a victory over Naomi? If I remember correctly, it was it was actually 100% of the votes for Ruth. Well, folks, I think it's pretty simple. If you know the story of the book of Ruth, you'll know that Ruth was was kind of the hero of that story. I mean, she was really strong for her mother-in-law. Naomi really needed her help a lot. So I think Ruth, it was just a pretty easy vote. And Ruth had great faith in that story to commit to her mother-in-law the way that she did, okay? So next up, we're going to look at her family. Now, we talked about this. Please remember, folks, if you need additional information, please go back on our YouTube channel and watch the first round video of these ladies. You'll hear their full story. But now, Ruth's family, we know, is, as we just said up here, Naomi was her mother-in-law. We know that she married a wonderful man in the story named Boaz. And we know that eventually their great-grandson is King David, okay? So they just had a wonderful family and a very spiritual family. Boaz was an incredible leader for their family. Ruth was an incredible wife and mother. So there we go. That is their family. Now, one of my favorite parts of our video is when we look at their personality. Folks, please carefully listen to these ladies' personalities, because this is where you get down to the core of who they are. With Ruth, there is one thing that stands out to me the most. When you look at the story of her, I see her willing to stay with Naomi, her mother-in-law. Even when she didn't have to because her husband died, she was willing to stay with Naomi. When Naomi said that she was going to go back to her home of Bethlehem, Naomi said, "I'm willing to go with you to your people. I want your people to be my people." And she said she was willing to serve the one true God, the God of Israel. Remember, Ruth was from this strange country, but she said, "Naomi, I want your God to be my God." She was willing for this. She was willing to go work in the fields of Boaz in the story. She was willing to wait at the end of the story to see if she could marry Boaz. So folks, it just keeps occurring in her story. Willingness. I think that's her personality. Ruth's personality, willingness. As I said, folks, you just see it over and over and over. She was a very willing young lady. And you could also put in there courageous. You see her, she's making some pretty bold moves. But I would say courageous would be second. I really feel willingness, that defines her to her core and the type of lady she was. And then I have a lot of fun when I'm preparing these videos with comparisons, because it just helps you, I think personality probably helps you vote the best, but I think comparisons helps a little bit too. I got to thinking, what person in the Bible, man or lady, kind of compares to Ruth? If you think about it, Ruth was under hard circumstances. She had lost her husband. She was moving to a strange land, and she was courageous and willing. And I got to thinking, and I said, what else was like that? And folks, it's another lady who is in this tournament, and I got to thinking about Queen Esther. I got to thinking about how Esther was in a hardship, just like Ruth was. Esther's people was in danger, and she was willing to do everything she could. So I think Ruth and Esther actually compare pretty closely together. Okay? So, folks, we could say so much more about Ruth, but we're going to leave it at this. You see who she is, a very willing young lady who does some wonderful things in her story, and eventually at the end of her story gets rewarded, and she's just a wonderful lady. But folks, please, as we now move to the second half of today's video, please give consideration for our second lady. I really believe that I know that we all know and have heard more of Ruth, but I guarantee you, if you listen, this lady, Mary, the sister of Lazarus, is just as inspiring in my opinion. This, in my opinion, this is so close. Please consider both ladies, okay? So, with that being said, we're going to look at the same things for this lady. We're going to look at her path so far in this tournament. What kind of victories has she had in our tournament so far? Okay, and then we'll look at her family. All right, then we'll look at her personality, and then who does she compare mostly to? Now, folks, I feel compelled to say very quickly, if you desire to vote for Ruth, please don't think I'm trying to talk you out of that. I said what I said to ask you, please don't shut out this lady without hearing her story, okay? Please remember the first round video is available if you want more information on her. Mary, the sister of Lazarus, here we go. In the first round of this tournament, if you remember, she had a victory in a video. With Eve, the first lady in the history of the world. Eve was ranked number 3 in our tournament. That's a huge surprise that Mary, the sister of Lazarus, had that victory over Eve. Okay, just looking back over my notes here, actually it was 100% of the votes. Not one went to Eve. For what it's worth, folks, I personally think that Eve didn't do very well in this tournament in votes. I think because, unfortunately, Eve, we don't know a lot of personal information about her. We know the story of Adam and Eve. I think Eve was a wonderful lady, but there's not a lot of personal things about her, like heartwarming things. Really, the biggest thing that we all remember is that she ate the forbidden fruit, you know? But I simply believe the reason Mary, the sister of Lazarus, had that victory is because she has just so many wonderful things about her, this Miss Mary lady, that it made it 100% for her. Who is her family? Well, if you know the Bible, you'll know that she was the sister of Lazarus and also she had a sister named Martha. Okay? Now, I'd like to remind you folks, in our first tournament we did several months ago, Lazarus almost made it to the final four. I think he was in like 5th place. So out of 32 men in the New Testament, he's an incredible man. This was an incredible family. I am getting ahead of myself a little bit here, but please remember, when Jesus and the 12 disciples were close to the area, they stayed at their house, at the home of Lazarus, Martha, and Mary. You see, obviously their parents must have been passed away because it looks like these 3 siblings were living together. Lazarus was the head of the household. That's why when Lazarus died, it was so tragic for Mary and Martha. Not only because they lost their brother, but because he was also the provider for them and the protector for them. So it was devastating, but folks, they had a wonderful family. These 3, the Bible clearly says that Jesus loved this family. Actually, we even believe that in the last week of Jesus' life, when he was in Jerusalem, We believe that at nighttime they would leave the city and they would go to the little village of Bethany. It was just outside of Jerusalem, and we really believe that they stayed the night, in the last few nights, at the home of Lazarus, Mary, and Martha. That was the last night's sleep that Jesus got in a home, was likely in their house. So, wonderful family, okay? Now, her personality. I must remind you that this is the Mary who sat at the feet of Christ, listening to his words. Do you remember that story? Martha, her sister, was busy doing the chores, doing the dishes and cleaning. And Martha got mad at Mary because Mary was sitting at the feet of Christ, just listening to his every word. And Jesus defended Mary. He said, "Martha, don't be mad at her. She has chosen the right thing." Now, of course, Mary would do her portion of the chores, but Mary wanted to listen to Christ. And we also know another story where this Mary, here again, she sat at the feet of Christ and she anointed his feet with costly ointment and wiped his feet with her hair. You see, those two things, those two events, shows me how devoted she was to Christ. To sit there and listen to his words and to anoint his feet is just telltale signs of her commitment and her devotion to him. Not just as a friend of the family, but as the Lord and Savior of her life. So I really believe the best word to describe this Mary is devoted. It shows in her stories how devoted she was to Jesus. Now, folks, please catch this. Excuse me. I'm not saying that Ruth was not devoted. That's not what I'm saying. And I'm not saying that Mary was not willing. I'm just saying those words define that person the most from what I see in the scripture. The last thing here, who does this lady compare to? Well, some people may disagree with me on this, but I got to thinking, who else did what this lady did? Who else wanted to sit right next to Jesus and listen and just soak in everything he had to say? I want you to think about the story of the Last Supper. Do you remember Jesus said, "One of you 12 men will betray me this night"? Do you know 11 of them began to panic? They said, "Lord, is it me? Is it me?" But there was one of the 12 who was sitting there leaning against Jesus, kind of like Mary was sitting at his feet listening. This one man sitting at the table was leaning on Jesus, and he wasn't worried. He was just listening to the Lord speak. We know this man as the Apostle John. Okay? The Apostle John. Now, as I said, I know some people will probably disagree with me on that. But folks, think about it. He, John, was the young disciple, the one who wanted to just sit next to Christ, lean on Jesus. And over, John was the closest one. Even at Mount Calvary, John was the closest disciple right at the feet of Jesus while he was on the cross, and at the Last Supper, leaning on him. So folks, I really see a similarity in that regard to this Lady Mary and the Apostle John. So folks, I must end the video. We're right at the 20-minute mark. I ask you to please consider which lady inspires you more. Is it Ruth, who we all know? If you're going on who's the most famous, of these two, it's going to be Ruth. But I asked you to consider which one inspires you more. If it's Ruth, please vote Ruth. If it's Mary, the sister of Lazarus, please vote her. But please vote for the one that it touches you the most, who they were as a person. So thank you so much for tuning in today. I hope you have a great weekend, and we'll see you back Monday as we continue our tournament. There's only about 1 week left to go in our tournament. So anyway, have a great weekend. Thanks for tuning in. God bless you.